My dear students, your accounting coach ARD is here. The topic of the day is cash book. Now, cash book is basically a book of original entry, also known as book of prime entry, which records transactions relating to cash and bank. Now, the cash book has a dual role. The cash book is also a book of original entry. Simultaneously, a cash book is also a ledger account. Why? Because all of the cash and bank transactions are firstly entered into a cash book. In this way, cash book is a book of original entry. Originally, all of the cash and bank transactions are recorded in a cash book. Now, after being entered the transactions in the cash book, we do not need to make separate T account for cash and bank, because cash book is also a T account, a ledger account. So cash book serves a dual purpose. It is also a book of original entry and it is also a T account or ledger account. Now, there are two variants in a cash book. One is two column cash book and another is three column cash book. In two column cash book, there are two columns, one for bank and one for cash. One is debit side. On the left hand side, this is a debit columns, and on the right hand side, these are the credit columns. And in a three column cash book, there is an additional column, one for discount allowed and another one for discount receive. Now, these are the three columns that we refer to in a three column cash book, one for discount, one for bank and one for cash. Now, on the debit side, the discount that appears is a discount allowed. On the credit side, the discount that appears is discount received. So whenever our customers are paying us the money earlier than they promised, then we are going to allow them some discount. This is known as discount allowed. And secondly, if we are paying our suppliers earlier than we promised, the discount that we are going to receive from our suppliers is known as discount received. So discount allowed is an expense for the business, therefore it is coming on the debit side. And the discount received is an income for the business, therefore it is coming on the credit side. Now let us start with a question in which we cover all of these transactions. Now the exercise that we are going to discuss today is here on your screen. Question number one, enter the following in a three column cash book of a bookshop. Balance of the cash book at the end of the month and show the discount accounts in the general ledger. We'll be discussing this in the later part of the video. Then in June 2008, all of the transactions relate to 1 month, that is June 2008. First, there are balances brought forward. Brought forward means opening balances, balance BD. We have cash of 420 at start of the month and we have bank balance of 4940. Now these are all of the transactions that we need to discuss, and now let's start this. So before going forward, I would suggest you to pause the video here and take a picture of your screen so that you may have the question for reference. I have made the column for you, and these columns would be given in an examination question, mostly in a CIE examination question. These columns are already drawn, so you do not need to write so many, make so many lines. Now we'll be starting with this. In the date column, let's see, there are two sides. One is left hand side and this is right hand side. The right hand side is known as credit side and the left hand side is known as debit side. So let us start. All of the transactions relate to the June. So I'll be writing June 2008 at start of both the debit side and then the credit side, so that I not need to write the June 2008 for every transaction. Now on the 1st of June, the balance is balance brought forward. This means opening balance. We have cash of 420 and we have bank balance of 4940. And the reference that would be writing is balance BD. Now I am reading the second transaction. You may refer to the question that we just saw. The following paid us by check in each case deducting a 5% cash discount. Following paid us means our customers are paying us, also known as our debtors. So whenever the cash or bank is coming into the business, a cash or bank would be increased or it will be coming on the debit side. And whenever cash or bank is going out of the business, the cash or bank would be written on the credit side. So in this case, our customers are paying us. First customer's name is Mr. Ali. So Mr. Ali owes us 820. Now he's paying us the money, so therefore he must be paying us earlier than he promised. So we have allowed him a discount of 5%. Now what we need to do, we need to apply a 5% to 820, means 820 multiplied by 5%, or 820 multiplied by 5 divided by 100. This is another way of calculating percentage, or you may use the percentage sign on your calculator by pressing the shift. And third, there is another way to do this. We need to multiply 820 into 0.05, because if we multiply with 0.5, 0.5 means 50%, and for 5% we need to multiply at 0.05. so in either case, 820 into 5% becomes $41. Now out of the 820 that he owes us, we have given him discount of 41. Now if I deduct 41 from the 820 total figure, the check that we would be receiving would be 779. So this is the amount that basically we receive. Now what would be the entry that we'd be making for it? Although the general entry is not required here, but just for the sake of understanding, I'm making a general entry for this. Discount allowed account would be debited by 41, because it is an expense. Expense would always be debited. And bank account would also be debited by 779. Because why? Because we are receiving this money. And the customer, that is Mr. Ali, would be decreasing Ali's account, because it is a debtor. Debtor is an asset. If the asset goes down, it would be credited. So this would be entry, discount allowed and bank would be debited and Ali would be credited. Now the similar transaction should be done for this. The second customer has paid Asgar. The amount for Asgar was 320. We need to multiply 320 by 5%. The discount would be 16. Now if I deduct 16 from 320, the amount would be 304. Thirdly, we have another customer, and all of the names start with A. Although it is a practice question by me, it is Akram, 440. So 440 times 5% would be $22 discount, and the amount that would be received would be 418. So this is important. If the question says we have received amount by check, we will be debiting the bank account. And if the question says we have received amount by cash, we will be debiting cash account. So the question will always tell you we have used a cash account or a bank. For example, if the question does not mention what have we received, whether in terms of cash or check, we'll be always be writing bank, because it's preferred to use bank account. And the last customer in this transaction is Mr. Amir. Mr. Amir owes us 1040, and the discount amount is 52, and the net amount would be 88. Now the thing is that one thing is important in an examination question, just to make sure that whether the amount that is written in the question has already been netted off, or the discount has already been deducted, or we need to calculate discount on the amount percentage. Now the hint for this is, if the question says the customer has paid his or her balance, if the balance of the customer is given, this means the discount is yet to be applied, and the discount has not yet been applied yet. And if the question specifically says that we have received the check amount, if the question says the check amount that we have received, means if the amount of the check is given, this means discount has already been applied and we do not need to apply the discount again. Now on the third date, there is a transaction, cash sale paid directly into the bank. If we have paid cash sale directly into the bank, the bank account would be increased, because the money did not came in the cash. Although it came in the cash, but we directly deposited that money into the bank. So the entry would be bank account would be debited and sales account would be credited. Now here we are just worried about the cash and bank account. We do not need to worry about sales account. So we just need to increase the bank account, and the reference would be sales. Then we are paid rent by cash. Whenever we are paying rent, our cash would be reduced. So cash account would be credited and the reference would be rent. The general entry would be rent, debit, and cash account would be credit. Now the next transaction is this. We paid the following accounts by check, in each case deducting 2.5% cash discount. So we paid the following amount by check, and now we need to deduct, in each case we need to deduct 2.5%. The amount, first supplier was Amar. Whenever we are paying our suppliers, the cash or bank would be reduced, and whenever our customers are paying us the money, the cash or bank would be increased. So we are paying amount to Amar. The amount for Amar is 360. If we apply 2.5% to 360, the discount received would be $9, and if we deduct $9 from 360, the check amount would be 351. Then secondly, we have another supplier named Afraz. These are all my friends. These are all fellow teachers. We teach in Karachi. Afraz. So the amount for Afraz was 960. So 960 multiplied by 2.5% discount would be 24, and the remaining amount is 936. Then we have Akshay. Akshay is not a teacher, he's a film star. We just put his name. So Akshay, 400 into 2.5% discount would be $10, although it's very small discount for Akshay Kumar, the big man. So amount would be $390. So whenever there are customers, they will come on the debit side, debtors, and whenever there are suppliers, they would come on the credit side. Then we have another transaction. This is important transaction. Withdrew cash from the bank for business use. So if the question says business use, this is not a drawing. A drawing is when we have drawn out the money for personal use or for home use. So this is a business use. Whenever we are taking money out of our bank account, a cash would be increased and the bank account would be decreased. So what we'll be doing, we'll be increasing our cash, we'll be debiting our cash, and then the reference would be bank. And in the same time, our bank account would be reduced. So bank account would be credited and the reference would be cash. So this is a contra transaction. As you can see, I have written C in front of them. What is C? This means a contra transaction. Contra transaction means if the cash is increased on the debit side, the same entry can be found on the credit side as well. So whenever an entry affects simultaneously both the bank and cash accounts, this is a contra entry. You may write C in front of it just to remember it. Okay. So if we are debiting cash, we'll be always writing the reference for opposite account. If we are debiting cash, we cannot write the reference for cash. So in a cash account, the reference would be bank, and in the bank account, the reference would be cash. The account that is debited would use the reference of the account that was credited, and the account that was credited would be using opposite reference, or vice versa. Then on the next transaction, on the 10th of the month, 10th of June, we have cash sale for 1260. Whenever we are selling goods on cash, our cash would be increasing, cash would be debited, the reference would be sales. And the next transaction after that is Bashir paid us their account of 280 by check, less $4 cash discount. Now this is not 4% cash discount, this is $4. Means the discount account has already been calculated by the examiner himself. So we don't need to calculate the discount again, we just need to write this $4 in the discount column. So if Bashir is paying us his account, so it would be coming on the debit side. So the discount allowed would be debited. If we deduct 280, if we deduct 4 out of 280, the remaining balance would be 276. Then on the 14th, next transaction, we are paid wages. Whenever we are paying for expense, our cash would be reduced. Cash would be reduced. Then secondly, we have another transaction on 16th. On 16th, we have another transaction. We paid the following account by check. Whenever we are paying by check, then this means it would come on the credit side. So we are paying Raza. This is my name. We are paying Raza $310 less cash discount of $15. So if I deduct $15 from the $310, the amount that we are paying to a supplier is $295. Then another one, he is also my friend Saranis. We paid Saranis $12. We paid him, the amount was $412, and we to deduct $12 in order to arrive at the figure of $400. So these are our suppliers. Then on the 20th, next transaction, we have bought fixtures. Fixtures is the furniture for the business, fittings or furniture. If we are paying for fixtures, our bank would be reduced by 4320. And then we have bought a van. We are paying for van. Again, the bank account would be reduced. Then we have received check from Arun. If we have received check, the amount would be increased. So the bank would be increased with the reference of Arun. Then there is the cash sale. Whenever we are selling goods for cash, our cash would be increased. Then we have stationery. We have bought stationery. When we are buying something, our cash would be reduced. So cash would be reduced. The reference would be stationery. So these were the transactions. Now let's move forward to the totaling part. First of all, what we need to do in a three column cash book, we need to total the discount columns. The total for discount allowed is 135 and the total for discount received is 70. Now the question clearly mentioned that we need to transfer these amounts to the general ledger. If you read the question, now show the discount accounts in the general ledger. Now as you may be aware of from your earlier studies, my dear students, there are three types of ledgers. One is sales ledger, one is purchase ledger, and then the third one is general ledger. In the sales ledger, there are all accounts for debtors, that is customers, and in the purchase ledger, there are accounts for our suppliers, that is our creditors, and in the general ledger, there are accounts for everything other than customers and suppliers would come in the general ledger. There are discount allowed, receive accounts, there are sales, purchase, return inward, return outward, and blah blah. So we need to make two accounts, one for discount allowed and one for discount received. So discount allowed is always debit. Why? Because it is an expense for the business. So what I need to do, we need to debit the total for discount allowed at the end of the month. So discount allowed account would be debited. The left hand side, as you may be aware, is debit, and the right hand side would be credit. And the date would be writing was for the end of the month. The month is June here. So on the 30th June, the reference would be total for the month. So what we need to do, we need to just enter the totals at the end of each month to the discount accounts, one for allowed and one for receive. So we need to credit the discount receive account. Now after that, what we need to do, we need to transfer these totals into income statement as well. I moved the video a bit forward. So what I need to do at the end of the month, I need to transfer this discount allowed into income statement, because all of the income and expenses accounts are transferred to our profit and loss or income statement at the end of the month. So if the discount allowed is basically debit, we need to credit it and transfer it to income statement at the end of the month. The entry would be income statement would be debited and discount allowed account would be credited by 135. The similar transaction, similar treatment should be done with discount receive. Although discount receive is credited, what we need to do, we need to debit this amount and we need to transfer it to income statement as well. So this is completed. Now let's move forward to balancing of the other part of the cash book. Now what I need to do, I need to balance this columns for bank. First of all, I'm doing for bank. So if I add all of these debit side for the bank and on the credit side also for the bank. Now the greater side that is coming in this question is credit side. So the debit side is less than 21392 and credit side is 21392. What I need to do, I need to write the greater amount on both of the sides. The credit side was already 21392, but the debit side was less than 21392. What I need to do, I need to add all of these values, the shorter side, and then deduct the shorter side from the total for the greater side. Now the difference that is coming at the end of the month is known as balance carried down. Balance carried down is the closing balance. So this balance carried down, closing balance, becomes balance brought down at the start of the next month. Now the next month after June is 1st July. On the 1st July, we'll be writing a balance BD, balance brought down. My dear students, if you can see, this balance brought down for bank is coming on the credit side. Left hand side was debit and the right hand side is credit. If the balance brought down is coming on the credit side for bank, this means this is a bank overdraft. We do not have any money at the end of the month. Instead, we owe this money to our bank. This means we have drawn out money more than that we have in our bank account. Now, this is a current liability for the business. So therefore we need to pay this amount to our bank as soon as possible or as soon as the bank requires us to do so. Now in the cash, a cash can never be negative. A cash account will always be positive. Either we have some cash or either we do not have. There is no such thing as negative cash. So the cash account would be always the debit account would be debit side would be greater side. And now if I write the greater amount on both of the sides, the debit side was already 3060. The credit side was not 3060. So I need to make it 3060 by putting a figure. And how to calculate that figure? If I deduct all of these items from the 3060 bigger side, I'll get the difference, that is the closing balance. This balance carried down, closing balance will become balance brought down at the start of next month. Now in the next month we have remaining cash. This means at the end of June or at the start of July, we are left over with a cash of 2124. This means we have more cash coming into the business and less cash going out of the business. So I hope, my dear students, you are able to understand. These is basically the marking scheme that is given by examiner. So I hope you understood the concepts. And if you did, kindly do write your precious comments. Thank you.